Welcome to the Under the Hollywood Sign on What's Up in LA channel. Get ready to dive in the daily routines of the dedicated individuals who make up the Hollywood industry. From actors to producers, writers to directors, and all the people working below the line. This show will take you behind the scenes and show you the real faces behind the glitz and glamour of Hollywood. My name is Fileehx. I'm co-hosting this show with Michel. We can see Michel here.
Guys.
And today we have a very special guest with us, Youssef Guezoum. Welcome, Youssef.
My pleasure to be here.
Yeah, an award-winning film composer, orchestrator, conductor, and sound designer with an impressive portfolio of projects and soundtracks, for major studio in Hollywood. Youssef's expertise in music composition has earned him recognition throughout the industry. He is best known for his work on the iconic Power Rangers series and the film Full Love, directed by Jean-Claude Van Damme. Join us as we delve into the world of Youssef Guezoum and discover the secrets behind his success in the competitive world of Hollywood music composition.
Great. Michel, yeah. Youssef, we are absolutely delighted to have you here.
Thank you so much for
That's
having
great.
Me.
That's great. One of my favorite composers.
Oh,
we have many tracks of you in the library, so we'll play some later, but we're very happy to have you. My first question is one I would ask all the composers. What inspired you to become a music composer? If you can tell us a little bit about your journey through...
That's a question actually a lot of people ask me, what did to push me to be as I am right now. It was, when I was little, when I was 10 years old, I remember. Actually, I'm from Morocco. I came from Morocco, and especially in Marrakesh, when I was really young guy. I have a guitar from my uncle, so sometimes I go and I pick it up and I play a little bit.
Right.
So I was not really a good one. So, but it's something that I feel it like I'm gonna be into this kind of industry. Like I like music, and it started from there. And then I buy piano, and when I was 13, my mom bought me a piano to play, and I see something serious in this field,
If I can, Youssef, because you're speaking about your young age.
Yes.
I have some picture to show.
Oh, yes.
So that's, let me show you. Yeah, exactly.
Ooh. This picture, okay, let's tell you this. It's when I was like 14 years old, this one. 14, yes.
Okay.
1989 in Marrakesh. And,
Christmas time.
A long time ago. and it was a piano there, and I play piano. It was not my piano, actually. It was for my uncle, piano from Russia, and he leave it when he go back with his wife. So I was taking advantage of this moment, and I jump on it, and I play piano. And it was start from there, I take it seriously from there, and now
cool.
It's become serious.
you were sight writing at this age?
At this age, no. Yeah. I just play, and I have some chord. I can read a little bit. As you can see, the partition is not for a young boy.
Okay.
I can play. I can, I can show you something.
Cool.
Good.
And I have another one.
Mm.
Maybe. Oh. Some years later.
Yes. So this one, 17 years old.
Yeah.
Like 18, 17. Yeah. It was north of Morocco. I have a band. This is my friend now. The other one is in Canada. Another one is a businessman in Marrakesh doing cars. So everybody jump other fields and doing other stuff. And I keep. It was bass. I was doing bass. I'm a bass player, and we travel all over Morocco doing music. We doing jazz. Yeah, it's crazy time, but I love this time. I remember that time. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Thanks for sharing.
You're welcome. So, yeah. And I'm so happy, by the way, Philippe and Michel. I'm so happy to be here and enjoy this moment with you and show the other people in the other planets.
It's our pleasure.
It's definitely a pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank for you. Sure. My second question would be, what got you started in the film industry? Because you went through that phase where you played live,
playing
with the band and playing piano home and stuff. I assume you have music instruction. You went to a university or you studied music. So how did you get started into the music composing for film?
Ah, good. Okay, let's start from the beginning. Actually, when I was in Marrakesh, I was doing music. But the music, it was just like playing with the band and, not scoring, not movie, not
right.
music for movie.
Right.
So at the meantime, I like movies. You know, when I watch the movies, it's always,
right.
you know, come out to my mind and blow me out, you know.
Right.
And say, wow, this is beautiful music. So the music makes you more deeply into the
involved,
film,
yeah.
involved in the film.
Oh, yeah.
So when I was watching the movie, always the music in the background push you and gives you more. So I feel in love in the music for film.
Uh-huh.
So going back to your question, when I came to Belgium, because I moved to Belgium when I was 17, 18, after the band, and moved, and then I want to make myself very serious in music, you know. So I studied music, studied classical music in the Academy of Jet, I remember, in Brussels.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can, you know, was like study all partition, solfège, all that. No,
all the fun stuff.
All the fun stuff. It's not, it's like a Japanese when I started doing this. And then I say, no, I'm not, I like music, but once I jump to my score, you know, writing, and I say, oh, it's too much work. But I was lucky to meet some teachers. They gave me different way to read music, different way and an easy way to how to write music.
Mm.
And then it started from there. So, and then going to Canada, I was in Canada, in Vancouver, by the way, study sound in Vancouver for 2 years.
Oh, I didn't know this.
Yeah, I was in Vancouver
for
2 years.
Yeah, okay, cool.
And come back, I was wanna go there, I wanna stay there. Yeah, I didn't bring my picture. I can show it to you. You should tell me this. And came back to Belgium,
uh-huh.
and I start doing my own business. So
right.
I start with commercials music for
okay.
for small
uh-huh. advertisement.
Advertisement.
Yeah, yeah.
And I do some generic, you know, like the opening.
Yeah, opening themes and
themes, generic, you know, jingles and all that stuff for pictures.
Mm-hmm.
And people like it,
mm-hmm.
and I make some money. I say, oh, that's I have to be careful about that. So I have to choose what I'm gonna do.
Right.
So it was going good until meet some friends from Belgium. They gives me some short films.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was experiencing my skills on short films without $0. You know?
Right. Unpaid
work. But it's my choice because I want to know and I want to get involved on that stuff. And I was lucky to meet some people who gave me their work. You know, you can meet someone, make a good short film and give you the film
sure.
to make music. So they trust me. And I think I was right. I did something good.
All right.
I don't want to judge myself, but they like it, you know?
Of course.
Absolutely.
You know?
Shouldn't be there, you know?
Yeah. This is the truth, by the way. But yeah, it was fun. And then met some people who gives me feature films. And then my career started from there.
So step by step,
yes.
going from short advertisement, jingles and things like that until you got...
You have
recognized as a composer and you got your first paid contract.
Definitely, you have to go through this path like from unpaid and a relationship, you know, build your
right.
partners, show your work to other people, you know, and then meet some agent and then you go step by step. Yeah, the field is very tough. You need patience and you need to love your what you're doing.
Right.
Otherwise, you're going to give up.
Right, 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 yeah. right, 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 right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Philip
wants to say something.
No, no.
What do you want to say?
Oh, I have to say something.
But yeah, you're right. You're right. I mean, it's heart-filled. You need to...
I have to say something now.
Go.
Okay, so how do you approach a new project? What's your... Do you have a process? Do you have a trigger?
Yeah.
What
do you mean? Like how I start writing music?
I'm very interested actually into the birth of an idea.
Mm.
Some people are triggered by different things. Some people are triggered by the script. Some people are triggered by visual cues, like a picture, an image, or some people just hear things in their head immediately.
Yeah.
Is there any specific trigger for you to start composing, creating?
Actually, it starts from before that. It starts from your meeting with the producers and the directors. And the chemistry must be set in there, you know.
Right.
You have to have this kind of chemistry between producers and directors.
Right.
And then if they like what they see and what they, because when you talk with someone in the industry, they're gonna ask you some question like if you know the field, if you know the music, if you like the movies and what you know about music. So technical questions, you know.
Right.
And then we go from there, and then if honestly, here's the thing. I start with script first. I read script before image, but I like watching the footage, you know, everything.
Whatever they can get you dailies.
Yeah, if they gave me any image.
To get into the mood.
To be in the mood. And
the same page.
To see what are you going to start and what's your vision. And if you're really wrong about some direction, the director going to give you more clue, you know, show you what he wants, what's his vision, you know. It starts from there. Mm-hmm. But
yeah, and there is the most difficult part.
Yeah.
To understand what he want to have, you know, because he may be
great.
He may tell you something, but for him, it's meaning another thing than you will understand. You know?
So I understand.
You really have to decode what is the
problem. There is a lot of talented musician, but the best one for movie is the guy who gonna make the right tone for the image. That's you need a lot of work on that. So. You can see there is a many musician, but some people they can't write music for film. So you need to feel it, you need to like it, you need to understand what you're doing, you need to know how to use your keys, your skills,
and
know how to play music, the chord, and you have to feel everything, you know. And then you have to understand what kind of music. There is many kind of music. And of course, you need experience. So that's why I told you I was working for not unpaid work, just to get involved in that industry, to know what you're doing. You know, I can tell you exactly. I did some mistake writing some short when I started, but I learned from that. You learn, no, this is what you're gonna do. No, the director want this, you know. But I learned, you know. Now, if I met someone. As a director, we talk on the same kind of level. I understand what kind of music they want. So this is a lot of research on that. But you need to be close to industry to understand how you're gonna start. You know.
Right.
So.
So and about this, yeah, you worked a lot with Claude Van Damme.
Yes.
As I know.
Yeah.
So maybe we can see some of.
Yes.
Some works with...
Yes, I worked with Jean-Claude. By the way, when I was in Belgium, a friend of mine, I was packing to go to US, by the way. Yeah. And since then, you know, we know each other, you know. So I was getting ready to go to move to LA, and I got a call in the middle of the night. My friend called me, Youssef, you know, I'm in the hotel with someone, but please, if we can come over here, it's going to be great. I say, you know, It's 10 p.m. I want to sleep. I mean, I don't want to go out. So, okay, if you don't want to go out, I'm going to give you someone going to talk to you. It was Jean-Claude Van Damme on the phone.
Hello, Youssef.
Yeah, exactly. Hello, Youssef. This is Jean-Claude Van Damme. I say, yeah, okay. I thought he was kidding, you know. But he was not kidding. He was Jean-Claude Van Damme on the phone. Say, yeah, I want to see you, and could you please come over here? We are here, and we want to see you. And then I feel it, you know, I hear Jean-Claude Van Damme talking. So I really ran over my car and just drive all the way.
Oh, you
to
went
meet him.
Through?
Yeah, really? So I meet him in the at night, you know, I meet Jean-Claude at night, you know, like
cool.
Midnight. So, and then we watched the the project together. He showed me some projects. I was talking about how I met Jean-Claude Van Damme. So I met him in the middle of the night, and he showed me some movies, and he said, oh, I need the music for that. And I heard a lot of things about you and from my friend. So he's very, very humble person, and he gives me his trust, and he said, I listened to what you've done before, and I'm truly want to work with you. So it was experience from that, and then it was a project that you can show if you want.
Great, because
let's do that.
Now
do
we,
that.
We can see the result of this night, you know. So here we have Full Love. It's a movie that you did.
It's Full Love.
So we're gonna see it. We're gonna see the trailer, I think.
Welcome to the White Rose.
I'm looking for a lady. I'm here to protect you. We're going to kill you.
A guy comes into my club, picks you specifically.
It got me.
Frenchie, I need your help. So you going to war over a lady? She better be worth it.
I have a problem.
Wow.
Yeah.
Love it. Some design, eh?
Exactly. A lot of action on that.
Yeah.
And
you like this action script. Movie?
Yeah, the story is really great, you know. And you know, Jean-Claude he likes doing something different. His own movie, the first movie he produced, by the way.
Yeah.
And then he directed. And he written by him.
Okay. Cool.
All right.
Yeah.
Great.
So
great.
Yeah, he did three things on the one and the actor, you know. It was
great.
Right. So they shoot it in Thailand.
Yeah, it looks like Asia. I've seen
Thailand and Hong Kong.
Maybe I've seen some Chinese characters.
Yes.
I think.
Yeah.
So I have another one named Ultimate Justice.
Yeah, Ultimate Justice with my friend, the producer Mike Leader from England, and he lives now in Hong Kong. He's a big producer. Yeah. He works with Jackie Chan and all these big names.
Great.
So I was lucky to score this action movie too with Mark Dacascos. And
cool. Let's see. You can comment if you want.
Yeah.
You know?
Sure. Yeah. They shoot it in Germany.
Okay.
Best security and personal protection service in Europe. Congratulations.
So you have a theme?
Good to see you.
Which is progressing.
This is a trailer. This is different than music and the score.
Okay.
Yeah. It was a nice project.
Okay. Yeah.
Sorry.
A lot of bad people.
A lot of villains.
Yes.
We need to be fast and effective.
I like Mark Dacascos. He's a great guy. Yeah. I met him in Santa Monica once.
He's good.
By chance. He was driving and he's very nice.
You must go find them, Gus. I'll take care of it.
Now he's in other big movies, Mark Dacascos.
Cool.
Yeah. Fun movie.
I just remember the French movie that he was playing the Indian in La Compagnie des Loups, no? Well,
yeah.
You remember that movie?
I think.
La Compagnie des Loups.
Yeah. Well, I forgot the title. I'm not sure that's the right words, but that was good. That was a great movie. It was really good in it. All right.
Cool.
Excellent.
My pleasure. Yeah, it was a long time ago, this project. I was happy to be involved in this project with them, and it's another opportunity.
So those action features, how do you approach different genre, different style of music?
You have a team, you start finding a team, the tone, score, and you build your orchestration through the image, you know, with the sound design. And I was working with the director. He was he has his own vision, so I was following what he was, you know, editing. We do a lot of sporting session together online.
Sure.
To put everything on that, and then we with the editor. So yeah, the post production is amazing because we make back and forth feedback and change everything. We can do it, and yeah, it was It's an action movie, you know. A lot of loud stuff and a lot of notes.
Incorporating sound design into your scores.
Yeah, some directors they like merging design with the score, with the tone of the music.
Yeah.
It's a new, it's a Hans Zimmer way.
Well, it started like 10, 15 years ago.
And it's amazing for movie design. Works really good. I mean, it's amazing. So yeah, it was a big pleasure to work with them, and now we have another kind of level in Hollywood, because when we leave here it's different, because it's a lot of competition here.
Sure.
You know.
Uh-huh.
It's competitive, a lot of talent. You have to prove what you can do, and
at the same time it's push you to work hard and stay in the good level. And but this, how do you stay up to date with the latest trends and technology, stuff like this, you know, because you have to stay in the loop, you know, of a new sound.
Absolutely.
And new
update or die.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. By the way, you've been pushed. You don't feel yourself doing this, because all updates, if you have this technology of the machine, as you can see in my setup.
So yeah, I have your studio here.
Yeah,
so
in Burbank. This is my studio in Burbank, close to Walt Disney.
Toys.
Yeah, a lot of toys and
plugins.
So yeah, and you have to be updated about that, and you know, following all this plugins, the VST. And samples,
Pro Tools,
all that stuff. So I was jumping. I was looking here, working with Logic. So I work with Logic too, and Pro Tools, and Cubase.
And paper.
And paper, yeah. Sometimes if you want to put some note, start from the beginning, from scratch, you write it down.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
great.
You know, and they have a big screen. Sometimes producers, they're gonna come up and watching what I'm doing. So you have to be ready for that stuff, you know. It's one of the things that makes you more active in your job. So you have to follow what the industry need, you know, and have all these tutorials and work, because we are in this industry, it's always updates, you know.
Sure.
You have to follow.
Yeah.
You have to be ready for that and learning every time. I read a lot of books too about music, and you know, I like for example Jerry Goldsmith. I like what all scores that he did before and all big names before, you know.
Yeah.
I like John Williams too, and all this new generation. I like some music from other friends, my colleagues here in Hollywood. They do beautiful work, phenomenal work. So everybody has his own style and touch.
Yeah.
And I have my own too, you know.
Of course, yeah. Which you know, I love.
Middle Eastern, Moroccan, folk
flavor of
you know, my
Arabic flavor. I love it.
Yeah, so
it's true. Actually, we got a bunch of tracks from you. We made a few albums with you, I think, and we got some tracks with an Arabic flavor, Middle Eastern, that is rather really great.
Yeah,
maybe we should play one of them quickly.
Oh, we
jump on it.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. We worked together, by the way. Long time ago, I provide you with a lot of.
Yeah, we loved it.
Yeah, and it's amazing.
So we have.
Let's play something.
Voice?
Yeah.
And this.
A lot of design, a lot of pad.
I can tell. Yes. I can tell.
So this is it, yeah.
Do you enjoy doing your own sound design?
Yes. It takes me sometimes, but it's part of score.
Yeah, this is good because you get emerging in a very large sound, you know.
What is this? It is a Middle Eastern one?
Not this one, but that's okay.
I can have another one if you want.
Yeah, this one.
Which one? I have Istanbul Rain.
Yes.
Istanbul Rain?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
There's another one, which is...
Which one? No.
It's Istanbul...
Yeah.
There's Alexandria. Do you have it? Alexandria?
Alexandria?
Yeah.
Let me check.
This one is good one. Do you like it?
Oh, I love this one.
I have a lot. Marrakesh Express?
Oh, that's I like it, Marrakesh Express, yeah. This is 100% Moroccan background, you know? Yeah. And we have like kind of a percussion, Moroccan percussion.
Yeah.
We call it bendir, you know? Ooh. It's called bendir. And it's 100% Moroccan, you know? Like.
Yeah.
As you can hear this kind of noise, you know, like in the end.
Yeah.
That's Moroccan percussion. I love it.
Me too.
It's at least four people doing this.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. And I balance it.
Yeah. Great.
Wonderful. Oh, you remind me the. Oh, la, la. It's a long time I've been doing this.
Yeah.
My last time it was like 9 years. 9 years ago. It's 9 years ago when I was writing this.
Oh yeah.
Maybe 8.
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah. But okay. It's good stuff. Thank you for doing this.
And can. I have a question. Can you describe the process of composing and music for a film? How does it differ from composing for a song, for example, or for other project, you know?
It's
What's the specificity to produce music for film?
It's different than than songs. You know, because film, you get to deal with the directors and producers, and a movie, you have some movies to watch, script to read, the vision that the director wants you to do it. So this kind of field is different than songs. Songs is, you know, you have process. You're a musician as well, and that people don't know, but you're a great composer too. And and people, when you write music for songs, you know, it's about feeling, about, you know, it's different, completely different.
Yeah.
I think the work, a lot of work in movies than songs, because you have a lot of time. Songs is 3 minutes, 4 minutes maximum. But the movie, it's sometimes 2 hours writing score.
Yeah.
And you have to stuck on the same, right. Stick on the same, and the same tone, the same vision, you know.
Right.
And it's a lot of work, a lot of hours writing music. But the songs is different, you know. I think it's different felt.
And do you like write songs? Did you?
I did it before, and I think I feel myself better in movies, because I work with myself. When you write songs, you have to deal with the singer, and you know how it works.
We know.
You know, Michel, he knows better than me too.
Exactly.
Yes, and especially if you work with the woman. You know what I mean?
There we go.
You know,
there we go. It's hi to
everybody.
Hi, ladies. So we have to be really. You have to feel what she wanna sing. You know, it's different.
Yeah.
Different.
Yeah, and you have to. Instead of movies and stories, you have also a story, but it's short story.
Yes.
It's just lyrics. So you have to serve the
and
lyrics.
And it's a lot of work too. It's a lot of work. You know, a lot of harmony. Yeah. Yeah. You know to do. We've done a lot of stuff. You know?
Yeah.
I know, and I listen to your stuff. It's amazing. You've done. Why you don't show this to people? One day I will make myself.
We will interview Philippe.
Okay, we'll do this. One time.
You have a huge background. Yes. And you've done.
I will
a lot
interview
of
Philippe, and I will ask the question that no one dare to ask him.
That we will do it.
Okay.
And I will come. I will sit in Michel's place.
Okay, great. I'm waiting for this.
By the way, when I meet you first time, you want something. You want the best score for something. You remember?
Oh, yeah.
When I met you first
time?
I won
the first prize for...
First prize from
it the... It was from the...
it's a big... it's competition. It's a
competition.
It's ASCAP?
Yeah.
It's ASCAP?
No, it was a competition from the music... how do you say this? A music plugger?
VST? Samples?
No.
Music pluggers? For like licensing?
Yeah, music
advertising?
Director.
Music director.
Like that, yeah.
Oh.
It was Hollywood music director.
Because
yeah,
you won the first place. I remember.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Bravo, Philippe.
But we are here to speak about you, you know?
Yeah, I know. So. But I like to remind you that you're a good one.
Thank you very much. Okay, and so now...
we want to hear more.
Yeah, and...
So,
and
see.
And
my new update.
Yeah, and but no, before, we know that you're an orchestrator.
Yes,
also.
Yeah.
And we have some footage. Of you,
yeah,
playing with orchestra. So, I think we
it's
should
exclusive.
Before we start, did you study music direction?
Actually, directing. I don't study how to direct, but I get some help from other friends who are really better than me on that. But so the musician in Sofia, they are very smart, and you know
they decode you.
I actually. This is the thing. My score, I know my score by heart. So it's hard to conduct something not yours. Because,
right.
You know,
right.
But you need to be a really good conductor.
Right.
But when I conduct my stuff, I'm
right.
The best.
Right.
You know,
you
me?
Know it by
heart. I know it by myself. I know it by heart.
Right.
I know what I'm doing. I know what I write. So when I direct my score, it's much better.
Right.
You know.
Of course.
So, yeah, we're going to see... you with the Orchestra? Yeah, no, it so was where was it?
It was in Sofia this year. Okay. I just finished a TV miniseries in Middle East. It's a historical series that it's going to be released soon. And this footage is just specially for you.
Thank you
very much. Exclusive and yes. Conducted in Sofia with amazing orchestra. It's Philharmonic Radio National Orchestra in Sofia. And I was so lucky to meet those people, to have the chance to direct.
And we know someone in common.
Of course. And by the way, I've been there through you. and I want to really thanks George if he listened to us.
Georgie, hi, we love you.
Yeah, Georgie, we love you. He's amazing. You're an amazing person. And I was as a king there. You know, he received me and the talented musician there.
Yeah,
very very smart and very good musician. All and
And George is from
GVR record. Yeah, I recorded with GVR record.
Do a great job.
Yeah, he did a great job. And he's very very talented and engineer.
Yeah,
sound engineer.
So let's see it now. Yeah. You can comment if you want.
Amazing cellist from Sofia.
Thank you to bring this.
Nothing beats real violence and real brass.
Yes, yes.
You can say what you want, but it's the thing.
This is the both instrument that I like, you know.
Yeah.
And with those,
the brass were really good.
Yeah, and I try to do something different, you know, when I write music, like put some flavor, some Middle Eastern with orchestra, ethnic music, ethnic instrument. And we can
hear it. Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, totally. I have the tone that it's in Arab, you know, the image and the footage and the series is a phenomenal project. It's a big and it's huge and you can see it's a lot of fight scenes. But when you match it, this is the end title. Mm-hmm. But if you hear the music inside, what I did, the album will be released when everything is in life.
Great.
And the score is different. So I think people will like it, you know, they're gonna enjoy listening to it.
We already love it here.
Yeah, thank you. This is a short video that I especially for you guys, you know, today.
Thanks a lot, you know. I told you to come here, you told me, oh, maybe I can bring some
I want to make it something different and exclusive for you guys.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah.
And share that with your audience and your fan and your people who are watching us now. It's a pleasure, you know. It's a pleasure to share this with you.
Pleasure is ours.
Totally.
My pleasure.
Cool. So,
quick question. You've been working with different genres and different producers and very, very different personalities. How do you handle the extreme spectrums of personalities that you have to deal with? Which can go from, you know, as we know, the nicest person in the world to the craziest one.
I know what you mean. I know. This is part of the game, you know. When you work on movie industry, so you have every different colors. And especially when you work with past productions and we work with different people, so we have to be ready for that's what experience works, you know. So come back to your question, this spectrum, that it's large spectrum, you know,
huge.
And you meet a star, you meet some people, really, you don't have time to explain. You have to be really quick learner and quick, you need to get it quickly, you know. Work with those big legends and big people in the movie industry, gives you push you to work hard, to have their level, you know, and give them what they need exactly. You don't have time. It's you know, and if you met someone who can't describe what he wants in music, your part, your job, you need to understand quickly, to describe it, right, and make it in music, the motion through the music. So you're part of the game, and you have to be ready for that. So otherwise, you're not gonna go far. You have to be really.
Do you ask a lot of questions to producers and directors?
Yes. It's like someone read a lot of books.
Yeah.
If you read a lot of books, you need how to read. You need how to write. So you need to read. So I watch a lot of movies, mm-hmm. and I watch different kind of movies.
Right.
From Marvels to Woody Holland and through Christoph Nolan, to, you know, all Scorsese.
Yeah, you have to get inspired.
To
by
get inspired,
everyone and do it with your own flavor.
Of course, and there is a lot of dark movie. You have there's some music that you can understand why they put, you know, like Scorsese.
Mm-hmm.
The music, there's this jazz in the movie, but it's a good score. It's good tone. It reflects what they see, what they want to say in the movie. Yeah, you have experience.
So you have to develop an extra skill in addition to all your composing.
I like your question because when I came here, by the way, I didn't say that. I was working in Calabasas for in studio. At that time, I was sharing a studio in Calabasas with Frank Jones. By the way, he's a friend of mine on Facebook. Hi, John. And it's not like I'm here from the studio.
Ten minutes away.
And I was working there, and I was doing music from 9 to 7 p.m.
Wow, okay.
All the day doing a lot of scores, a lot of soundtrack for the and the production that I share with them, they told me, by the way, say hi to Jeremy and Jason from Facebook. They're owners for the studio. So the deal between sharing studio, so I can make music with them and I can share the place, not paying rent.
Right.
So I work for free. I they get this thing for free, but I work for them. You know, I write music for them. So I do a lot of soundtrack, and in the end of the week, if they get something that they like it, my mission it was done. You know, so from this studio, I learned a lot of things. That's big studios, big clients. For example, PGA Tour. Mm-hmm. I was working night and day to get this idea to if they like my music. So, yeah, you have to know how client works and what they need. You have to be a lot of people want to make music, and it's competitive, as I said at the beginning. So you need to...
You have to have something extra. You have to have a competitive advantage.
Yeah, and people, some people write score easily and quick, you know. In 3 minutes, you can have a 3 minute score, 3 minute soundtrack. Some people write it in 1 hour with the samples, and it sounds great. And they give it to the producer. They say, yeah, we love it. And then they jump to the orchestra. But you know to handle these samples. You know to go close to the real orchestra. Some people don't know if they write soundtrack, if they write music with Logic or Cubase. You need to be close to the real orchestra. Because director, they say, oh, it's going to sound good. But maybe better with the orchestra. Yeah, of course, with better orchestra. But at least you have some kind of what
a
it's going to be. What's
yeah,
going to be?
Template. You have
template.
A temp.
But you need to convince them about your music. For example, I work recently with my friend, orchestrator. He writes music in old school, in old way. But when he sends me samples, it doesn't sound the same.
Right.
But I'm what I want.
Yeah.
But my stuff, it was close to orchestra, but his stuff far away. But the score written as we want and everything, but it doesn't sound the same, you know. The orchestra is much better. When we jump to Sofia, it's amazing.
Right.
It's beautiful.
Right.
Yeah, it's. I like your question.
All right.
Okay, cool. So, I would like, so I have vulnerables. Also,
it's a short film.
Can you explain it?
Vulnerable. We can have some images, right? Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So Vulnerable, it's.
I can put the image on
it's,
you.
Yeah, it's French, Belgium, French short film.
Mm-hmm.
It's for MMA. It's for a young girl. She fight for to show herself, her attitude, her personality through the fight. So it's called Vulnerable, and she's an amazing actress from Belgium. She's a Moroccan Belgium girl, and by the way, she's in real life fighter.
Oh, she's a real fighter.
She's a real fighter,
mm-hmm.
and she make it this movie, short film, amazing, phenomenal job she did. I work with my friend Noon, the guy who do editing with Jean-Claude Van Damme.
All
he
right.
called me. It's produced by Dragons Films from Belgium, and we did a great job together. I like the image, the scenes. We can watch it now, right?
No.
Not yet? Okay. So we can have it later.
Let me see, because there's something got strange. Yeah,
okay. And it was amazing project with Noon. It was amazing. And
how long was the movie?
Almost 14 minutes.
Oh, okay.
It's a short film.
Okay.
Yeah. And the we send it to Cannes Festival.
All right.
Watch it, they like it.
All right.
And now it's a brand new project. So people, you will see it in soon in.
So
in
the
YouTube.
Actress is a real fighter.
The actress is a real fighter.
She's a real competitive
and
fighter.
Yes.
Ultimate fighting.
And she has his own story, by the way. It's
okay.
Close to her real life,
oh,
you know,
yeah.
Because they're.
I have the.
You have it. So
now I really want to see it.
Oh,
okay.
Nice.
Yeah.
And because their parents, they don't like it to be as a fighter, you know, like. It's a shame for a family. But she liked to do this. She want to be a good champion, you know.
She looks tough.
She's very tough. By the way, her husband is the guy who do.
Who do what?
Who's maintaining the fight in the middle?
Oh. Cool.
Yeah.
All right. We want to see it.
Yeah. sure. They will. It will be done soon on platform.
So.
And yeah.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. It's
so
it's
now, yeah. What's your future project?
Oh,
because
that's
you told me there is some exciting.
You want me to say that in public? Yeah.
It's up to you. You know, I
no, we, just ask my question.
Yeah, of course.
No, of course, I will be happy to
no
share
hesitation.
My news.
Yeah.
No, of course. No, the reason to come here and talk about my work and share something, I will share it in the future, but it's going to be exclusive in your show, in the podcast. It's a pleasure to say that. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
So my future project is going to be with the, I'm not going to say the name. It's a big name. Director that I was surprised to have this project. Not surprising, but I was shocked that he's an amazing person. He's a very humble person, director. And he's a well known as a director. It's gonna be on Netflix. It's a mini TV series, shoot in Cuba, Mexico, Turkey. It's kind of a crime mini series. It's called, I can't say the name now. It's called Deep State.
Cool.
You know, corruption.
Excellent. So a lot of flavor, so,
yeah,
exotic
congratulations.
Music.
Yes.
Does that get you excited already?
Yeah. I watched it. I watched all. It's eight episodes.
Yeah.
A lot of chase scenes, fight scenes. It's a high level quality. It's when I watched it, I was talking with the director. It was, wow, that's a lot of work. It's a lot of work on that, you know? A lot of work. So this is my first project. It's coming soon, and I'm gonna reveal the name soon about the director, because I'm gonna make it.
Are you done with the music? Did you finish all the music? Are
no,
you
we got no, we get no, no. We're gonna start.
Oh,
we,
you're starting.
Just,
okay.
Start working with together, and I receive all episode and everything now. Just my news update, that's gonna be sure, you know. And the next one is a movie with Netflix too, with the director in Middle East, a big dark movie, very comedy, crazy story, a lot of explosion. I love the idea of the movie. It's my first movie with Netflix. I always do mini series and a series TV show. This one is a movie with big names on it, and I'm so excited to work on this.
And we are too.
Thank you. Thank you. So I share this exclusive news.
Any ETA as to when they will be released? Next year?
It's going to be, no, this year.
This
gonna
year?
Be, yeah, this oh. year, this year. Deep State this year.
You don't have much time.
Yeah, I don't have much. I have like 3 months work,
oh
by
boy.
The way. I already set my orchestra and when I'm going to do all the music already. And I'm so happy to work on that kind of project. Yeah, I know. I just finished a project. I need a break.
No.
I need a break, Joel. I
mean, no vacation for you.
No. What do you think, Philip?
Come on, it's your. It's
I was working
this
on.
This is your life. What break?
Yeah, right.
Come on.
I was working on a previous project for 3 months and just finished it, delivering everything, and we're happy and going to be released soon. And then I say, oh, now I have some time for me. I'm going to take a break.
No.
Maybe go into Morocco with my kids and my wife. No way. So
no
they,
way.
They will go without you.
Exactly. That's hurts, you know. But I'm so happy, you know. Sometimes this is part of life. This is part of our business. So
of
we
course,
have to be ready.
You're worth it, you know.
Yeah,
I'm really happy for you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you. We,
yeah, really.
We start from scratch, me and you, from LM when we come the first time. Yeah. By the way, Philip, we know each other through a friend of mine, Vanessa, our lawyer.
Yeah.
And she introduced us through emails. And she told me,
exactly,
this is Philip. He's in LA too. You're going to meet him. He's doing music. He's a composer too. But we didn't meet through this email. And I met him by chance in a party. And he was talking French. And I said, oh.
You talk French?
We talk French. I say, oh, you're French. We talk French. And then since then we're friends. And I admire his job, what he's doing. And I wish you the best, man, you know. You're doing great.
Thank you very much. So thank you very, very much.
My pleasure.
Yeah, to come here and
it's a pleasure.
Tell us some Little secrets.
Some secrets, some exclusive.
Okay.
I hope that's gonna hurt some people, you know.
No.
No.
Oops.
You know, I mean, no, I'm so happy to be here, by the way, and it's a pleasure to share with you all my stuff, and I wish you the best, guys. You know,
we're delighted. And if people want to hear more from Youssef, you can go on musicpartner.tv. And he's got plenty of tracks in the library as well.
Yeah,
yes, exactly. Yes. I was so grateful to work with you and to have this partnership with you like long many years ago and share music. And you have a good, great platform and that people can license in the music and movies and everything.
Yeah.
And it's amazing work you've done, guys, both of you. And yeah, it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you.
And I hope one day you come back with more more news. And
we want more music, for sure. Yeah.
More music, and we can share with all your audience.
With pleasure.
Yeah.
Youssef, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Pleasure. And we'll be back next week with another guest.
Exactly.
Okay, bye everyone.
Bye-bye.
And thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.